Hello guys, and welcome to Till Vacuum Do Us Part. Sorry if there's an echo. I'm standing in a house we just signed for yesterday. So if you guys follow me over on Instagram, you guys got a little sneak peek, you got a little alert. So if you're not following me over there, definitely click on the link down below and make sure to follow me over on Instagram if you kind of want to have those sneak peeks and know what's going on before it happens. But Chase and I decided to buy a second house, and that's what I'm standing in now. It is an older home. It's like, I think around 83 years old. It's in a really like trendy and cool area here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. So it's about 30 minutes or so away from like our current house. We are not living here. So a lot of you guys were concerned that we were gonna be selling our old house. That is gonna definitely be where we stay and we're living. I do not have it in me to like pack and remove, but this is gonna be more of a house for our family, our friends, and we're also gonna Airbnb it. So we've had 3 contractors in. We just met with one now and I think he's gonna be the winner, but we're doing like a full reno here and we're gonna make it new and fresh. And then everybody can come stay in it. We kind of have been looking for ways just to start making money outside of YouTube. You guys kind of got to understand that, as I will be here as long as YouTube and you all allow me. But Chase was ready to just kind of have a new adventure, and it's just a really cool thing to mark off our bucket list. A lot of you guys were guessing that it was a flip. A flip is something I'm dying to do, but I'm gonna see how this one goes before we jump into something like that. But Chase is just super excited about doing an Airbnb. He knows I love like decorating and cleaning and hosting. And then he does, you guys know, all the finances, numbers. He knows how to make everything I love to do make money. So it's amazing. So I'm so thankful for him. But now I'm gonna stop talking. I'm gonna walk you through this house. It's cozy, so I'll kind of talk about what I'm wanting to do to it, and then make sure you're subscribed because you're gonna see all of our reno as we just transform this home. So I want you guys to stay here. I want you to be a part of it. Thank you guys so much for all you do here on this channel. It makes all of our dreams come true, and we're just so thankful for each and every one of you. So let me show you around our new home. I can with lighting. There's a lot of like natural light, but it's super dark in the rooms until we get like daylight bulbs. But this is our living room. So it has the original hardwood floors, which we are going to keep. We will be like repairing all the walls, either skimming them, whatever we gotta do. So that's why we're waiting to hear from like the contractor. We're gonna paint everything. I'm gonna actually take these out because they're kind of placed in an awkward position. They're not like centered. Basically, these used to be outside windows, but they built on an attached garage. And so they just walled these up. So we're probably gonna take those out. I'll kind of come here from a different angle. So the pieces we can't do, we're gonna go and piece out. So some of the stuff we can't do, some of the stuff we can do. If we can do it, we're gonna do it on our own to save money. I'm gonna paint this door black on the inside. You can't tell from here, but the baseboards are really rough. So we're gonna get new baseboards. Obviously, I'm gonna work on this fireplace. We're gonna hang a TV, put a cute rug down, sofa, 2 chairs, entryway table, all of that fun stuff. So we're just gonna make it super cute and fun. This is our dining room. So when you walk in, we have this space. I'm not sure if they were using this as like their pantry, probably. But since nobody's gonna be living here long-term, I'm just gonna get super organized where I have bins in here and labeled, kind of like my laundry room, where if people forget stuff, I have it in here. It'll be overflow, you know, first aid, all sorts of stuff. I'm just gonna have this closet stocked for anybody that stays here. The doors are staying, obviously a new light. We're gonna repaint this whole little space here. The kitchen and the bathroom obviously are the worst areas that we're gonna be spending most of our money on. I'm gonna turn this light on, but it's gonna get kind of orange. So basically everything needs to be like just knocked out of here, taken out and redone. So we're pricing new cabinets. We are gonna leave all the appliances where they are just to save money. And then we're gonna buy new appliances just cause these are kind of older and it has been like a long-term rental. So I just wanna get everything fresh and we're gonna get new countertops, obviously a new sink and faucet, but we have a cute little kitchen window. We have two windows over here, but what's funny on this side, there's like not much cabinet space or countertop. So we're gonna put lowers down here with a cabinet up high. I think we're gonna take this guy out even though it's super cool. Look at this. It's like for all your spices, but it just depends. So what we're gonna do is like take this wall down. So we're just gonna kind of cut into it and put lowers and make this kind of like an island with bar stools. So while you're cooking, you can still see whoever's eating in here and have people sitting here at the bar. So I'm trying to make it like as open as we can, but it is a small house and it is old, so we don't want to put too much into it. This does go out to our back patio. I'll go and show you that while I'm right here. So it's like a really big area. It's actually a really good size yard to like be in town. And then our neighbors are building a ginormous house, which I cannot wait to see it finished. I'm sure it's gonna be a dream home, but we do have this really large deck. I can come out here so you guys can see. We already have a shed, which is super nice. It's gonna be kind of loud just cause like I said, there's construction going on. Now the outside is gonna be completely painted. So we're gonna paint everything white. We'll have to stain the deck. We'll probably do that ourselves. But just to kind of get an idea, it is red brick, but it'll have a lot of white and black accents, kind of like our current home does right now. So I have a lot of yard work to do, if you can tell. Like we have a magnolia tree, or the neighbors does. They have like this bin. So we've got a lot of like cleanup, but you guys know that's what I do best. But this is the culprit right here, but I can't even complain because it's so pretty and just brings on so much shade in the evenings. Okay, so I'll take it back inside. What's nice is both of these open up too, so you can like, there's not many days you can keep your doors open in Oklahoma, but the ones you can, it's super nice. Okay, so now we're gonna take you over here. This was originally the master bedroom. I've been tearing this out. I've been trying to figure out if it's wallpaper or what, but look past the craziness. This used to be the master. And it had this closet right here. You know, they're fine. I have an OSU chair in there, so we're here sitting. But somewhere along the way, they added a walk-in closet over here. And I guess at some point, they had a door and closed it off. So we're gonna just, not us. The contractor's gonna like shiplap this and fix it from the outside and inside. I can't really show you guys on camera. It's hard because of the angle, but basically I'm gonna turn this into a really cool kids room. I'm gonna have two twin beds coming out. I'm gonna have like a nightstand in the middle. I'm gonna have like lights hanging above them over their bed. I don't know, it's a small little space, but nobody's gonna be here long term, and I'd rather have more beds for like bodies to sleep. So if you have like a large family, so I think that's gonna be so cute. It does have a door on it if you like, if you need privacy. It's got airflow in here, all of that. So we're gonna redo this whole space, make it really, really cool for kids. And then, sorry, I'm gonna run out of breath. This is just a lot of talking. So in here, we're gonna add a bed, two nightstands. I've got some rugs picked out. We'll do a dresser and then a TV. And so I've slowly been like picking out stuff for these rooms. This is what I'm gonna assume was the guest bedroom, just since the other one had the built-in closet. But I'm gonna make this the master because it's still a really large room. I'm gonna put the bed coming off in between the windows. I'm gonna have a dresser, a TV, a chair. And like I said, these all have closets, but when you're only staying like a couple days to a week, you don't need much storage. So we're gonna like skim coat these, have it painted, all the cute little bench for you to like put your luggage. Rooms aren't gonna be that bad. Those are pretty simple, not too hard. Paint everything. They do have like really weird tiny crown molding with a gap in it. So we're just gonna take all of that down and just make it like clean and flush. But once again, all new baseboards everywhere. I know you can't tell, but up close they've like seen better days. This is actually where phones used to be. So this house is so old. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and leave this because it's just a sweet little thing to look back on because it is an older house no matter what we do to it. So on to the bathroom. Once again, it's like, it's a two bedroom, one bath house, but we, like I said, we're gonna use the closet as like a third bedroom for people coming in to stay. But what we're thinking about doing is taking this whole piece out, getting a bigger vanity. I'll probably do floating shelves for extra storage or add drawers. And here in the shower, this is actually like super duper low. Like I don't even think, I mean, Chase could shower, but his head's like touching the ceiling. So we're gonna knock this out and raise it, get a whole new shower. We're probably gonna keep the tub to save money. It's still in really good condition. The toilet's new. I wanted so bad to replace this tile. I'm just not a fan of it. But the way it was installed, you know, like 80 years ago, it's like right on concrete. So you have to take all the concrete out underneath it. So I think I'm just gonna hire somebody like Stanley Steamer. They like stalk me on all my accounts. Like their ads keep coming up and it cleans it really well. So I think I'm gonna have that like professionally cleaned just to make it look new and fresh again. All new paint, all new lighting fixtures. You guys know me. I'm gonna totally ashlify this space as much as I can. But that is it. Like I said, it's a super cozy house. I think it's around like 1,100 square feet. Over here, we're gonna clean this up some. We're gonna get rid of the tile here and then like square this off and paint the whole thing. I'm thinking about painting it black because a lot of the walls are just gonna be white. But time will tell. I thought about keeping these and just knocking the shelves out and hanging something in them. So if the budget gets crazy, that's always an option too. There's so many things we just really don't know until we're in it and what we're gonna find, just like this. Like we don't know how much ripping out the walls. So as soon as we take this off, we have to skim the walls because this is like the plaster behind it and it has to be skim coated. So we've got to work on all that. Our contractor, we're waiting to hear from some bids, but I kind of want to paint the doors black. Let me know what you guys think about that. I love black interior doors, but this is her. So it's going to be really busy for the next, like I'm guessing 2 to 3 months, just getting this house like renoed. And then after that, things will slow down. So of course I have like a huge long list of things I want to get done, but the main things are to get like the main areas fixed. And then on days when it's not being rented, we can come in and add like a DIY wall or change something up. So it's one of those things we'll have like professional pictures taken, but when you show up, it may look completely different because we've added a cool feature or something. So I'm really excited. I'm really nervous. It's overwhelming. It's something we've never done, but we're so excited just to try it out and to see how everything turns out. So we're gonna take you along the journey. Airbnbs are really hit right now, at least like in our area and surrounding states. Tulsa or even Oklahoma doesn't have many cool places to stay at, but we're 2 blocks away, if even that. It's like a 4-minute walk from the Gathering Place. If you've never heard of it, check it out. It's a really cool park that a billionaire, local billionaire created, and it's all free to come visit and see. Anytime we're over here, I'm always like, I don't feel like I'm in Oklahoma. So it's gonna be really cool with friends and family and other people can come hang out here and we can go visit those areas together, spend some holidays here. I don't wanna say ever, but I didn't wanna do a long-term rental. I really wanna be able to get into my home. If I own it, I wanna be able to come in, clean it, check on it. So we're thinking this is the perfect way. I would love one day to maybe do a flip. I know a lot of you guessed that. Hopefully that'll come one day, but I definitely gotta get through this house first and we'll just see. But thank you guys so much. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Definitely make sure you're subscribed. We have tons of reno videos coming. I will be going back and forth, so I won't just share footage of this house. I'll still be doing normal content as well in the other house. But It's gonna be a wild ride. I hope you guys are ready. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I will see you guys in the next one.